So again, we have used the ratio test to show that this infinite series is convergent. Really, it's absolutely convergent. And therefore convergent. So what do you think? Do you like this?
Yeah.
I do too. I'm glad that we end on one that is nice like this. Damn, what about something like this? Okay, something like this, I'm going to do very quickly again. I already mentioned that factorials increase faster than exponentials. But what if the base is 1,000? So here the factorial is in the numerator, and the exponential is in the denominator. So what I'm telling you right now is I will guarantee that this guy will diverge. But it's alternating in what I'm telling you. So let's go ahead and use the ratio test. So I'm going to take the limit as n approaches infinity of the opposite value of. I'm going to put this negative 1 to the n up there, right? So it's going to be negative 1 to the n plus 1 times n plus 1 factorial. So I'm going to say n plus 1 times n factorial. Divided by 1,000 to the n plus 1, which is also known as 1,000 times 1,000 to the n. And then divided by the nth term, which is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal of the nth term. And this is what I have. Make sure that that makes sense to you. Does that make sense? Okay, so now let's cancel out the n factorials and the 1,000 to the n's. And let's look at this as a limit. I also want to look at this right here, right? This negative 1 to the n plus 1 divided by negative 1 to the n, really I'm just left with a negative 1 in the numerator. Agreed? Because negative 1 to the n plus 1 could have been written as negative 1 to the first times negative 1 to the n, and then those negative 1 to the n's would cancel out. So I'm just left with a negative 1. But as soon as I take that outside of the opposite value, or I apply the opposite value, then that's going to go away anyway. Right? So let's look at this limit. What does this go to? If the numerator is negative quantity n plus 1 and the denominator is 1,000, what does it go to? Inside the absolute value marks goes to negative infinity, and then absolute value it goes to positive infinity. Does that give that this is inconclusive, or does that give divergence?
Divergence.
Therefore, that guy diverges by the ratio test. So again, the ratio test could give convergence, and if it does, it's absolutely convergent. It could give divergence, or it could be inconclusive. So I want to do an example of okay, the root test is really only used when the entire expression is raised to the n power. So something like this. right? They have this expression, and the entire expression is raised to the nth power. So this gives allows us an opportunity to use the nth root test. So we're going to take the nth root. And let's remember what the nth root test says. It says we take the limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of the absolute value of a sub n. So the root test says take the limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of the absolute value of n over 2n plus 3 to the n. Well, we can see that the numerator and denominator are both going to be positive, so that absolute value doesn't really make a difference. And the nth root of something being raised to the n power, those guys cancel each other out. And so really I just have that this is equal to, we'll leave the absolute value marks in there because it's not going to make a difference. What does this go to? The degrees are the same, so it's leading coefficient over leading coefficient, so it's just 1/2, which is less than 1. Therefore, this guy converges absolutely. And therefore converges, right? And we would say by the root test. All right? You see what we got going on here? Now, this is day one, and we're going to be doing this for 3 days. So there are some more challenging types of problems within these, and we'll talk about those once we get to them. But for now, this is a good starting point. And then we'll talk about, what if this is inconclusive? What if one of these tests is inconclusive? Then what do you think we're going to have to do? Try another test, right? But if ever you see a factorial in there, the first thing that I would try is the ratio test. Or a combination of factorials and exponential and polynomials. Do the ratio test. If the whole thing is being raised to the n power, you go straight to the root test. And that's that. Easy enough, huh? Right. Sweet. Let's look for something as easy as this. You already know what this does. What does it do? By what? Correct. Let's try to use the ratio test. Let's say, oh my gosh, I love the ratio test. I'm going to use it all the time. Great. We take the limit as n approaches infinity of n plus 1, so absolute value, n plus 1 to the negative second over n to the negative second. Which is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of n squared over n plus 1 squared. Do you see that? I could bring that down to the denominator and then make the exponent positive, and that up to the numerator and make the exponent positive. And then what's this equal to? 1. Uh-oh. Inconclusive. Meaning you cannot use this test for this series. It doesn't mean that this series is difficult to evaluate, to determine whether it converges or diverges. In fact, we know that this guy converges because of the p-series. But all that this tells us is you cannot use this test. Here's the biggest thing that people get mixed up. You ready? So look at me. some tests, greater than zero gives us something. Like, for example, the limit comparison test, when we take the limit and we get like one for the limit comparison test, that's a good value to get for the limit comparison test. That tells us that they do the same thing. Any value greater than zero, right? Any real value greater than zero for the limit comparison test. Yet for one here, that's a bad value to get because it tells us that this test is inconclusive. So sometimes when people get zero, they say, oh, that's inconclusive. No, 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 not for the ratio or root tests, but for the limit comparison test, that would be inconclusive. Or if they get one, if the limit is equal to one, well, sometimes that's good, sometimes that's bad. For these tests, that's bad. Yet for the limit comparison test, that's fine, that's good. So that's the one thing that people kind of forget. They think they have it memorized, or you know, they think they know those tests as well, but then they kind of get them confused. You can see how that could happen, yeah? All right, good. Your homework for tonight is the first 20 problems in this section. So page 578, 1 through 20.